I snuck to a window to leave her alone. Will you come meet me at the back of the grove? All the trees were in bloom, that sweet smell in the air. We were trembling together.
All right. Hey, YouTube, what's going on? Matt, AF5ST.
I'm Darren, KG5, ABO.
Today we're going to build a 2-meter, 5-element Dawn's Extreme Dream Beam. It's a well-proven antenna, and Darren and Landon have built this antenna and videoed it before. I'm sure most of you guys have seen this video, but I wanted to build this antenna finally, myself.
With updated plans, because we made some improvements.
Right, and Darren said, oh, wait a minute, before you go and build it, I've got some updates. And I went like, well, I didn't see anything about any updates. And he goes, well, now would be a good time to update the video. So
right.
This is what we're doing.
The parts list, which is found on my QRZ page, which is Kilo Golf 5 Alpha Bravo Lima on QRZ, you can find the picture that has all the parts. You'll need to make one trip to the store. That's important, I know. And everything is updated here. So if you'll get everything on the list, you should be able to put this together if you have some tools. And
how long is it going to take?
It depends. Your first one could take all day. I'll just tell you that right now. That first video was well edited.
Well, I'm hoping that we get this done in one evening. So
I've actually made it simple enough. You should be able to do this in 4 hours. And that's pretty good. That includes the detail work.
Sounds good to me.
Right. And that's a really fast antenna. The gain on this antenna, it's kind of open for speculation, but we're predicting anywhere from 12 to 14 dBd. And it has proven itself time and time again. You hook a 5-watt radio to this thing, it's like hooking a 75-watt amp to it. It's really incredible. The gain you're going to see, put it up about 40 feet for the optimal results or higher if you can. We're going to show you all the materials, so you can get to work on this. And what did we spend, like, how much?
It was just under $80.
Yep.
And no expense spared.
Right. You're gonna have a great antenna. You're gonna be the loudest one on the air in your area. Let's get to work.
All right. All right, guys, what we're gonna need is you're gonna need 2 10-foot pieces of this 3/4 PVC pipe. Now, you're gonna have to make sure you get the tough stuff. Okay, and you're also going to have to get 2 of these 4-foot length dowel rods. They've got the black on the end, so you can identify them pretty well. And you're going to need 35 feet of gauge H copper wire. You're going to need a split T with the split T has a threaded end, so you're going to have to get the 3/4 slip with the threaded in there, so that goes in the bottom of that for you. Okay, now the rest of these pieces here is you're going to need 2 of these T pieces, 3/4. You're going to need 3 of these 4-ways, and you're also going to need 1¼" union. Okay, so that's what you're going to need there. Now you're also going to need 2 hose clamps to go around this slip T.
What size are those?
Those are 11/16 to 1¼. Okay, so just double check them when you're there at the hardware and make sure that they will fit. Okay, that's what, you know, double check everything. Okay, now we've covered all that. You're going to need 10 end caps, 3/4-inch end caps. Okay, a bag, it has 10 in it, so that's, you're good to go there. 6/32 by 1/2 inch stainless steel machine Phillips screws. Okay, 6 by 32, 10 of these Nylocks, stainless steel, everything stainless steel. Okay, 6/32 by 2 inch pan Phillips 2-inch screws there. Your washers, number 10s, and you're gonna have these terminals. The best sort of terminals to get are stainless, but these ones here are copper with a
a silver coating, so they're good to go. And then you got your silicon 30 minute ready, water ready, and then your tape for making it, you know, camouflage it or whatever. And that's about all you need. You're gonna need to cut a few things. You're gonna also need these stands here. Darren's telling me that this antenna will never touch the ground once it's built. So you're gonna need something to, like a jig or something like this to hold it off the ground. So let's get started. All right, guys, what you got to do is pretty easy. All you have to do is cut all the sizes of the pipes the same size as what he's got here on the plans, okay? The first one is 11 and a half inches. So we'll need two of those. So we'll do that. Okay, I got all these cut. So what we have here is 11 and a half, 12, 12 and a quarter, 12 and three quarter, 13 3/8. And now we're gonna get to gluing.
All right, one of the greatest improvements that we made on the Don's Extreme Dream Beam, and thanks to AE5UN, none of this would be possible without that man. He's an awesome ham. We found that we could actually, instead of trying to fish that big long loop, which had to be a straight wire to go through this, we could actually notch this, and it's on the plans. You'll see a slit made in these. So what we're going to have to do behind here is we're going to make a notch right here with the drill bit spinning, and that will, or you can use a hot soldering iron or something to make this notch. Now, to get it the right depth, I've pressed this cap all the way on here, and I've made a line right here. Now, this is about where the wire will be, so we're not actually going to push this all the way to the back of the cap. It's going to push against the wire. So there's going to be a little play left in here, and that's going to hold the wire. We're going to seal it with some sealant when we're finished, and that will allow it to hold the wire very firmly, and we don't have to worry about fishing that long wire through this PVC pipe, which is really a hassle. And that's one of the biggest improvements. It'll speed this up considerably, and so a little tricky, but it'll make a big difference.
So based on what Darren just said, I'm going to use this drill bit, which is close enough to the size 8 wire.
What size is it?
About 13/64. So that's close enough, and it won't, you know, it'll go in nice and easy. So no, we'll try that and see how we go. Always remember to wear personal protection. Now, the last thing you want to do is be working on something and your whole project go away because you forgot to wear your personal protection and protect yourself and people around.
Almost to the line, but not past that line, so that we can press up against that wire.
Right.
So that's how you do all the pipes that have these slips, which is half of your antenna. And do all of them, and you'll be ready to glue the things. All right, when you're assembling these, one of the most important things to remember is that notch has to be glued straight up, so that when you're doing this, the straight up piece is straight up, and it's only on one side. All of these are notched, and we're gonna have screw holes in all these. So these notches have to be straight up.
So when you glue this, you get one chance with that glue, you know. So you're going to have to force it in there, be sure, and just make sure it's straight up. And he's got a beautiful blue glue. Straight up now. All the way in, straight up.
Yep.
All right, he's got it straight up. All right, we're going to put this together. Now on this, I show center to center, this piece here. I'm going to give you this measurement when we get this done. This measurement here of 18 inches is the center to center. I'm going to get you the pipe cut measurement here in just a second.
All right, we got all these glued. And you can see that they're in a Yagi configuration.
Yeah.
Okay. You can see, and with all the notches straight up. Okay. And now what we're going to do is we're going to now give you the measurements from these inside. Instead of working from the outside, we're going to give the inside measurement from one element to the other.
Okay? All right. So you'll just be able to cut the PVC the exact length we say instead of trying to figure it out.
Right.
Because the plans say center to center. We're going to do the math for you, make it easier.
Okay.
All right, we're doing this, and Matt has cut his thumb. Look. All right, and notice, look at me, Matt.
Yeah.
He's not wearing his safety glasses.
See,
that is why.
Always wear the safety.
That's right.
Protection.
So be very careful doing this.
This wouldn't have happened if I was wearing my safety glasses.
That's right. If he had his safety glasses on, this probably wouldn't have happened.
Okay, so
okay.
Later.
All right.
Yeah, we'll make it easier on you.
All right. All right, we're going to make it easier. We made a little boo-boo, but we're fixing it. All right. This long piece here, this is your reflector, and we're going to give you the measurement from here to there for this PVC cut. Measure that piece you've got in your hand that we've already pre-cut. And this will give you the exact measurement to make those 18 inches. What do you got?
16 and 7/8.
All right, 16 7/8 is how long you're going to cut the reflector.
16.
And that's going to make these two 18 inches center to center. So there you go. What was it?
16 3/4
and 16 7/8.
All right, so about 16 7/8.
Yeah, a little bit won't kill you.
Yeah.
All right. And we're going to glue that, and we're going to continue down the line here.
Sixteen 3/4.
All right, so for the driven element right here, this pipe cut between the reflector and the first director
16 5/8
is 16 5/8. That's what you cut the pipe. It'll give you a center to center distance of 18 inches.
You're looking for a center to center of these two elements here of 18 inches. That's what you're looking for.
Yeah, so. And you have to do this on a flat surface. Okay. And you want these straight up and on all the same sides.
You see here, center to center is 18.
Alright, and that's the reflector. And this is your first, this is the driven element, actually. So, very important. No, wait a minute.
Show the power supply you're using.
Let's look at a power supply. More important. Okay, there's one thing I want to make really clear. If you look at this, there's parallax here. This looks, if you look at this drawing, like this is the longest section. It's not. There's a parallax involved here. This is actually the shortest one. So when you're putting this together, take note that there is a parallax involved here. This is the shortest one, and they get larger as they go toward that end. So be really careful. Look at your measurements when you put this together so that you don't make a mistake like we just did. We messed up, but it's okay, we fixed it. But there's parallax here, so be very careful and make sure that this is the small one, and they get larger as they go this way on these measurements when you're cutting these sections in between here that go in between these Yagi antenna configurations. All right.
16 3/4.
So this is the shortest pieces. This measurement right here that you're going to cut to make these center at 18 on the short end. The parallax kind of throws you off here. But what is that measurement, Matt?
16 3/4.
16 3/4 is what you're going to cut that one. And when you piece these two together, the shortest pipes should come out 18 inches center to center.
If we check this now, just to check it.
It's full of glue in it.
This should be how far?
12 inches center to center.
It's a little bit, but I bet you if we...
Don't do it yet.
Yeah, there you go. That was that quarter of inch that I needed. There you go. 12 inches. Perfect.
All right, this is the shortest.
Okay. It's off. Ugh. And we need to take this off. Ugh. Okay, are we ready? Okay, guys. We're going to give you the cuts in between the reflector and the driven element, okay? Now, starting from the reflector, your first cut's going to be 13 1/4 inches, okay? That will give you a 14 1/2 inches from your first coil to your second coil, okay? Then, from the driven element to the first director, it's 7 3/4 inches.
All right.
And from director 1 to director 2 is going to be 10 3/4 inches.
The cut.
The cuts, okay? These are these cuts, these pieces here. Okay? So the first one's 13 1/4. Next one is 7 3/4. Next one is 10 3/4. And then 16 3/4. Okay? So remember, you start from the reflector, 13 1/4, just like that. Okay? At this point, this is when you're going to put the dowel rod in, because if you don't put it in now, your antenna will not be good. Okay, so we're gonna put the dowel rod in, and then we're gonna go to the next stage. Okay, we got the dowel rod in. We got the Yagi configuration all correct, and now we call this the fish bone. So now we're gonna cut our wire and we're gonna get up on this jacks here, because from now on this antenna will never hit the ground.
All right, we've got our copper, and the first one we did was 82 1/2. That's our reflector. And let's show them the end real quick so they can see that. Yeah, you're gonna do it like this. And this is where you're measuring from, where it actually is the sharp 90 degree turn there. You're gonna measure right there. So you wanna have two of these, one on each end, and you're measuring between that curve right there and the next curve on the other end. So the first one was 82 1/2.
82 1/2, that was reflector, which is here.
Right, and our next one, I believe, is our driven element. Let's see. Our driven element, the length on that one is 78 5/8 inches. Now, consider the screws are part of your antenna. So the half inch screws that we use will be part of the length of this actual driven element. So don't worry about the measurement, it's 78 5/8, and the screws will make it upright. So we're getting all the bends out of it. You can see we've got the element just kind of stuck in there. We'll straighten it up later. We'll screw it on. We'll get all that done. Okay. All right, now your screw is going to go right here. Now, you can push these back and forth a little when you're done. But the trick is you need to leave enough. Kind of just take that one out of the way. To just at least get this cap started. And some good sealer right there. That's fine. Right there. So you would mark your mark right there, like we did, and that's where you're going to drill these all the way through. And you're going to do that all the way down the Yagi. So these caps, they only go on a little bit, but just enough to be good and sealed when you're done. you know, maybe an eighth of an inch or so, maybe even a quarter if you're lucky. But you mark each one like that. Make sure you get your cap on.
What you're looking for is you're looking for the distance in here, the same distance that you have, the same distance that you have here. So you're trying to replicate that here.
Pretty close, yeah. Right. But you have this bend that kind of throws you off, and this will be movable in that screw. And it's gonna, so you have a little play there of safety. So just kind of do it like we said. You're watching the back of this wire to make sure you can still get a cap on.
Okay, these holes that you're going to drill here for your screws are approximately 5/8 from the edge in 5/8. As you can see, you just have to leave enough room for your cap. We've just put the wires on the ends here just to hold them. But
yeah, we'll straighten them up later.
Basically, it goes like so.
Right, and the turns of these are going to be facing in that way.
Right.
All right.
Okay, so we got all our wires cut and we've crimped around the edges and we've got them screwed in. You can see we've got the screws all the way through. We got our end caps on. Now, when you tighten these down, it will oblongate the ends of your elements, your directors and all that. So with these, your caps will keep, will sort of be on really firm. But you still glue them on, and that will hold your wires. We've got our wires close to as round as possible for right now. But what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna show you what we do as far as the connector. Okay, now we have 1/2 inch, 6/32, two of them you've got your center conductor and your ground. Now we have done a mechanical connection and also an electrical connection, okay? So you've crimped them and soldered both connectors, okay? The coax will run along this union. Don't forget about putting your union on. Once you got this on, then you can snap your union on and it'll just snap on real tight. And then
Amazing. You
caulk all this real good.
Center that.
And waterproof it and make sure it's not gonna get, it's gonna last you for years to come. Also, With the coax, just zip tie this all the way along, come along your center, then down. This is going to come down the center post. Now make sure that you put your second dowel, this is that other dowel you had, and make sure it goes right up to the top of the mast there, because that's going to be the weakest point of your antenna. Okay, so make sure you do that, and the hose clamps. Now, with the hose clamps, you put those two hose clamps here, and the reason why you do that is because if you're gonna be running sideband, then you would reposition this straight down for sideband. All right, we've got our wires cut. We've got these connected to our end of our directors. Now the screw goes all the way through. When this crimps down, it's going to oblongate the end of this director, and the cap will go on firmly, but make sure you still glue them on. They need to be glued on, okay? As you can see, it looks good, but it still needs some fine tuning.
And this is 2 inches of unshielded coax.
Right.
Very important, 2 inches unshielded.
Right. What we did was, when we put the dowel rod in the pipe earlier, we put some silicon in there, so it stayed where we left it. So you could probably do the same, and that would work out great for you.
AE5UN, JG5, big deal.
Pat.
Hey, Don, how's it going?
Oh, it's going. We're still got the shiny side up for now. How are you doing?
All right, so it works awesome. Phenomenal, actually. And we're going to put this up in the air and try to hit some distant repeaters with it. And we're going to put it on an analyzer and look at it on the analyzer to see what we got.
All right, so we checked out the antenna. We tested the antenna on Simplex and a few local repeaters. And working real good, full quiet. Simplex about 40 something miles away. So that's a good stretch. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna check it on the analyzer and make sure we're good. We're gonna check it from about 136 megahertz all the way about 174. We've noticed that we also got 70 centimeter repeaters. So, and they're really far away. I think, what was that one, about 50 miles?
Yeah.
So which repeater was that?
Little Rock somewhere.
Little Rock. Chenal Mountain somewhere. So that's a good stretch from here.
Yeah, for 70 centimeters. That's...
Yeah. So
it is not resonant on 70, but your SWR looks good. We've checked right. It before, so it is usable on 70.
Was it the harmonics there that's working there? Or
probably, yeah.
Okay. Well, what we're going to do next is we're going to check it on the analyzer, and we'll see how we go. So here's 141.32, 320 megahertz. So we're good all the way from there. And there it's resonant at 145, 146.520 resonant. And all the way up to, you get about 1.8 at about 152.
Right, so the entire 2 meter band is good.
Yep.
Good job. And so there it is, and that's the updated video. So
yep. All
right, wrap it up. You know, give us a wrap up.
All right, wrap it up. Thanks to Don 85UN for bringing this to light, and also Darren KG5ADL. Now, just remember, everybody, this is all about fun, having a good time. And the enjoyment of making your own antenna is second to none, and getting it up in the air and talking on the airwaves is what it's all about. So if you just remember, if you have any questions or anything, please contact, there'll be a link somewhere around here, and you can contact Darren and he'll be able to help you out with any problems that you might have. So enjoy, and this is Matt, AF5ST. And we'll catch you on the air. 73.
So our mirrors on the ceiling, and pink champagne on ice, another
someday for you and me in paradise. Give me an old school guitar, an 8-bit lo-fi porn star. I promise that I'll take you to the paradise in hell. And so again and again, we're playing this game. We wanna see our name in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. I'm playing guitar, I'm playing a game, but for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Hey, it's Matt here, AF5SD, along with Darren, KG5ABL. What we're gonna do today is we're going to are we going to finish this off today, or are we going to do, we're going to do the 7?
We're going to convert this into a 7.
Right, that's what I thought. Okay. I just want to double check because we got so many projects going right now. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to convert this 5-element Dream Beam, 2-meter Dream Beam, to a 7-element Dream Beam. There's going to be the second one, I think, that Darren has made. So what we're going to do is we're going to modify this. And we're going to turn it into a 7-element extreme Dream Beam.
Maybe Dream Beam Ultra?
It's not a beer, dude.
Well,
it's a whiskey.
It's not light. That's true. All right, well, what's a strong whiskey?
I don't know, but I'd really, really would like to get it on an analyzer and compare it side by side with a five element and actually see if there is going to be any difference. I know the actual the concentration of RF is going to be tighter, but is it really going to at the end of the day be monitorable and see if there's actual a difference? So that's going to be interesting to see. So let's get started with the modification. First thing probably we're going to do is we're going to have to take off this last director on the fifth element. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put these two, if I'm not mistaken, we're going to put these two directors on. So we have to make sure that our other directors are the same size, or you know, in line with what they have to be.
Fifth element support will be 11 3/4. That's the cut you make. You make two of those. One has a slit, and one is supposed to have, it doesn't here, but it's supposed to have a drill hole through it. This will be 11 1/4, your cuts for both sides, 11 1/4, 11 1/4. And these will be 11. These pieces here are, I believe, 16 3/4. 16 3/4. That gives you a center to center of 18 inches for these last two elements that we're adding. The gain on this should be about 14 dBd. And you'll notice here we've done the same thing that we do for the mast. We're going to cut this off about 24 inches or so. We're going to get above the elements and we're going to make a bridge. It won't be a wire, it'll be a non-conductive wire. And we're going to support this internally with either a fiberglass rod, which we don't have, so we're going to use some wooden dowel, and we're going to make sure it's good and strong, and then we'll finish it like we do the normal 5-element beam. We're just adding elements. It's that simple. The measurements of these loops are 68 inches. That's between your bends, 68 and 66, and it's just that simple. So that's all you have to do. We're going to get back to work, and we'll see how it turns out.
Okay, so we were only able to get 4-foot dowel rods, and we need a 8-foot dowel rod for this antenna. So what we've done is drilled out the centers. I got a small, you could use this small bit of dowel, or you could use something else, whatever, as long as it's not conductive. And just glue it together. And you're good. So we could use wood glue would probably be best, but my wood glue ran out, so we're going to use some epoxy resin.
All right, it's getting much straighter.
And the bridge that we're going to build, we'll finish that off.
Okay, so we got the dowel in it now. As you can see, there's a lot more rigidity to it. And so what we're going to do now is we're going to put the wire elements on. And we're going to get them somewhat circular. And then we'll work on attaching them to the actual to the frame. That looks better. Definitely looks better. Okay, here is the 7-element. Extreme beam that we built, and you can see, I don't know if you can see this in the video, but this wire is a suspension wire. It's holding the actual antenna, being as long as it is, it holds the antenna up and keeps it firm. It also has a dowel rod in the middle, and once we cover it and we put the driven element on, we will the coax on the driven element, we will put it on the SWR meter and see analyzer and see how it performs.
Yeah, we've still got a lot of work to do, detailing, tightening, straightening, and we need to put a 4-foot dowel rod in the pipe down there, but it's coming along really good, so hopefully we'll have it finished before too long.
Okay, so we got the antenna up. We're about to put on the analyzer. Just remember, folks, keep always, when you're putting end-up antennas, be careful of overhead power lines, and also check the weather. Make sure you don't have any lightning. We don't have no lightning, so we're good to go. Let's throw this thing on the analyzer and see how we go. All right, we got it set up to the analyzer. 146, 520, we're at 1.2 SWR. We're looking really good, and if you watch the SWR, we'll take it up to 147, 148, still at 1.2, and 149, 1.3, 150, 1.4, 151, 1.5.
How high can you go before you hit 1.9 or so? So it's
152.
So it's usable almost to a, yeah. So about 152. What about the lower end?
It's 146, 520. There's simplex. 146, 145. 144.
Moon bounce.
Yeah, 144. 144 is 1.6.
Keep growing now. See what 1.9 is on SWR. So
143.
So good job. KG5 ABL.
Hey Darren, you got a nice signal in there this evening. How are you?
Straight from the man. Yeah, we have a tremendous amount of trees here and everything also, so it would be, and we're only 9 feet, so. But thank you very much for checking it out. We're making a video, and we appreciate your participation in that.
Always, I'm always glad to help out, and just sorry that I don't have the time to play around with that kind of thing myself, because it sounds like a lot of fun. You guys have a good evening. WX0X.
Yeah, we appreciate you. 73, have a good one. WX0X, KG5, ABL. All right, it's definitely working really good. Not even up in the air, and we're getting very distant repeaters. So be careful if you build the beam. Always observe all your safety precautions. Lightning, personal protection, grounding. Make sure you don't become a silent key. Have fun. Thanks for watching. 73.
73.